Look at the shit I spoke about. Look at the shit I put in these people's ears. Man, I feel very wrong about a lot of things. How many lives I actually am responsible for when it comes to my music?
What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host of this YouTube channel. Back with another video. I recently came across a clip of this popular rapper, NBA Youngboy. He recently had a revelation that perhaps his music has been sending the wrong message. Perhaps he's been contributing negatively to society through his music. Well, you think?
It's flooded with millions of dollars from the time I was 16 all the way to this point in my life. And I woke up one morning and I was like, damn, they got me. Man, look at the shit I spoke about. Look at the shit I put in these people's ears. Man, I feel very wrong about a lot of things. How many lives I actually am responsible for when it comes to my music? How many kids and people have gotten a car or put this shit in their ears and actually hurt someone? And now I'm sitting back like, damn, I can't do it all in one day, but I promise to clean whatever I can clean. But it's gonna take time.
Among the myriad of voices in the music industry that want you to believe that they're actually doing numbers, you can pull a SoundScan report on any of these artists and actually see most of these artists aren't doing numbers like they proclaim to be. NBA Youngboy is one who is, which tells me that he has influence. And I'm mainly concerned with his decision to use that influence and reach to make a positive impact. He's admitted to himself, and now he's admitting to the public, look, the music that I create, the images that I pump into the atmosphere have had a negative effect on the community. And I own that. Now, people I talk to on a regular basis about the music industry, we call this phase when the smoke clears. Because they keep you in a fog in your early years in the game. You're on flights, you're on stages, you're doing concerts, you're in clubs, and the smoke is everywhere and you can't really see what's going on around you while you're being manipulated and while people are taking advantage of you and stealing your money. And then you reach a point where the smoke begins to clear. You get clarity. You begin to see things for what they really are. Seems that NBA Youngboy may be reaching that point where he realizes that his music is a detriment to society, particularly Black society. Because let me tell you something. Although young white suburban males are the biggest purchasers of rap music, they tend not to live the life in a song. So for them, it's just music. It's just a fantasy. They're LARPing through NBA Youngboy's music. But when it comes to little Black boys in the hood, and you talking about drug dealing? You talking about killing? You talking about sliding on ops? Man, that's their reality. So for them, you're validating the things that they see every day. If you can make that comparison, then it's easy to see that NBA Youngboy's music has a different effect in the suburbs than it does in the hood. And I'm not naive to the fact that sometimes you got to do the dirty work and get in the mud to get those coins in order to reach a point where you can have a positive impact. Some people never make it there. Let's hope that NBA Youngboy's realization is authentic. Understanding the damage that he's done may inspire him to do some positive work in the future. And let's pray that NBA Youngboy brings some balance into his life. The way to do that is to overwhelm the negative of your past with the positive of your future. Make this a pivot point, NBA Youngboy. Turn this thing around. Use your platform and use your influence to show these young kids that there's a better way and denounce the negative messages of your past. You can do it. And your positive influence moving forward will be much more impactful than your negative influence of the past. Like the video. Subscribe to the channel. And share the video so we can get more musicians involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time. Peace.